Anthony Show. From Club Anthony, high above the fabulous Sunset Strip, the Ray Anthony Show. Tonight, featuring the story of the big band era, with a host of exciting guests. Now, here's the star of our show, Ray Anthony.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Club Anthony. Tonight, we're going to present the story of an era. An era when all of the nation was crazed by the sounds of the great big bands. Many of our guests here in the club were part of this era, helped to make the musical history we're going to recreate for you tonight. I, too, was privileged to be a part of this period, and I'm proud to say I helped create portions of this history. When I was a youngster in Cleveland, I first became aware of the name bands when I heard Glenn Gray and his Casaloma Orchestra on a radio broadcast. I must say it was a great thrill. Right now, you're listening to one of the songs Glenn Gray is still remembered for, No Name Jive. Ladies and gentlemen, that was Glenn Gray's original arrangement of No Name Jive, Abe Most on the clarinet. You know, around the late 30s and early 40s, one of my greatest musical impressions was created at the New York Paramount Theater when the King of Swing at that time, Benny Goodman, featured the perfect combination of Martha Tilton singing, Ziggy Elman playing, and the Angels sing.
Song I ever heard. You speak and the angels sing, or am I reading music into every word? Suddenly the setting is strange. I can see water and moonlight gleaming, silver waves that break on some undiscovered shore. And leave
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. That, of course, was Vicky Carr, our own Vicky Carr, singing the vocal chorus, and our great all-star trumpet section helping out with the trumpet part. Thank you again. You know, big bands used to be identified by their sound. Here are a few examples. For instance, Guy Lombardo used three saxophones and played a very simple harmony, such as this. A little different when Billy May used slurping saxophones, and he made it sound something like this. Thank you. Glenn Miller created a great sound when he added a clarinet to his saxophone section, and his sound was something like this. Along came Claude Thornhill, and he just threw out all the saxes and used clarinets. Along with his piano, his sound was a very pretty one, and it sounded like this. Sounds were made in other sections of the band, such as the trumpet section. For instance, Horace Hite and Hal Kemp use triple-tonguing trumpets. And if the boys have their tongues in place, let's try that. Hal Kemp. There were other gimmicks used in making sounds. For instance, what was his name? Shep Fields and Lawrence Welk created their rippling and bubbling, bubbling rhythms by going as far as using a glass of water and some, let's see what we have here. This is Lawrence Welk's theme. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Not only were the bands identified by their style, but also by the sound of the instrument their leader played, such as Tommy Dorsey's trombone, Harry James' trumpet, and, of course, the distinctive sound of Artie Shaw's clarinet on one of the biggest selling records of all time, Begin the Begin. Ladies and gentlemen, say, how many of you remember those big band broadcasts from Glen Island Casino in New Rochelle, or maybe the Aragon in Chicago, or here at the Hollywood Palladium? Well, tonight we have with us one of the many greats we had the pleasure of listening to on those particular shows. Tonight, repeating one of those, or recreating one of those broadcasts, the one and only Charlie Barnett.
From Frank Daly's Meadowbrook on the Brompton Turnpike, here is the music of Charlie Barnett.
Charlie Barnett, see what memories. Charlie, thank you so very much. You know, friends, after the Second World War, when I started my own band, the disc jockeys, well, they had seemed to have taken over the radio time. Therefore, records became important again. One of our first big hits on record was one we'd like to do for you now, Harlem Nocturne.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. You know, within the great name bands, many stars were born. For instance, Benny Goodman featured Gene Krupa on the drums. In his trumpet section, he featured Harry James and Ziggy Ammon. And, of course, the great vocalists Martha Tilton, Helen Forrest, and Peggy Lee. Our next guest is a man who sang with the great Duke Ellington band and went on to become a top vocal star in his own right. Ladies and gentlemen, Herb Jeffries.
Flamingo, like a flame in the sky, flying over the island to my lover nearby. Flamingo, with your tropical hue, for it's you I rely on, and a love that is true. The wind sings its song to you as you go, a song that I hear below, the murmuring pearl. Flamingo, when the sun meets the sea, say farewell to my lover and hasten to me.
You know, Herb sang with the great Duke Ellington band. Herb, would you come up and join us? We'd like to do Duke's A-Train. Can you lead the band?
Well, I must confess it'd be a pleasure, but this is a first for me. I'll take a try.
Oh, you'll be great. Give us a downbeat.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Now saluting the great Lionel Hampton, here's our own Kelly Green at the Vibes with Flying Home. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the second half of our story of the name band era. And here's Woody Herman's great arrangement of Woodchopper's Ball. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you. You know, when I was 18 years old, I had a great opportunity to audition for the number one band in the country at that time, Glenn Miller. I was very fortunate in being being able to become a part of that great organization. Along with many stars who came from the Glenn Miller Band, was one of his arrangers who now fronts his own organization, a man who arranged such great hits as Anvil Chorus, American Patrol, String of Pearls. Here tonight to lead our all-star band in one of his own compositions, String of Pearls, is Jerry Gray. Let's all welcome Jerry Gray. Jerry? Recognize that as Stan Kenton's great arrangement of Artistry in Rhythm. As we said before, many stars were born in these great big bands, and our next guest gained her fame with Stan Kenton's great band. Here she is. Let's all welcome very lovely Ann Richards. How about that? Ann Richards, Ann, that was just beautiful. Lovely girl. You know, along with motion pictures, ladies and gentlemen, television has played a major part in the band business. Some of the dramatic TV show themes have become as popular as the shows themselves. We had a hand in helping this along with a couple of our million-seller recordings. See if you recognize these.
We'll be right back.
not deceiving you. This is really Les Brown in person. You know, Les, no band show is quite complete without you. Welcome to our Club Anthony show.
Well, thank you, kind sir, and it's a pleasure to be here, really.
Thank you very much. You know, Les is responsible for as many hit records as any band leader in the business. I mean, things like I've Got My Love to Keep Me Warm, Sentimental Journey. Not only did he make a hit, but he made a hit actress and singer in Doris Day.
Yes, we were very lucky to have Doris with us for two different times, by the way. Once for a year and a half, another time for three and a half years, 5 years altogether. And whatever happened to her? I never seen her.
Well, that's a long story. But, Les, would you be kind enough to recreate some of those great arrangements?
We'd love to. And how maybe about Sentimental Journey?
Can you use our Vicky Carr for...
We'd love to. She's beautiful.
Wonderful. Les Brown, ladies and gentlemen, in this great hit arrangement of Sentimental Journey with Vicky Carr to help along.
Lovely Vicky Carr, and I think Doris was that age, just about that time.
Gonna take a sentimental journey, gonna set my heart at ease. Gonna take a sentimental journey to renew old memories. I've got my bag, I've got my reservation, spent each dime I could afford, like a child in wild anticipation. I long to hear that all aboard. Seven, that's the time we leave at seven. I'll be waiting up for heaven, counting every mile of railroad track that takes me back. So yearning, why did I decide to roam? Gonna take a sentimental journey, sentimental journey home.
Dear, we'll be seeing you in the movies, too, real soon. And by the way, my son, Les Brown Jr., will be recording that real soon, so watch for it on Liberty Records. And I hope you remember this one. This was a few years after Sentimental Journey. Irving Berlin's I've Got My Love to Keep Me Warm.
know, the one song that every band in existence has played at one time or another is the great Count Basie composition, The 1 o'clock Jump. Boys. Well, folks, that sort of winds it up for tonight. Those were wonderful years, weren't they? Good night, everyone. Thank you.
Saying good night, everybody.